You think it's time for me to get a haircut?
I think it's time to get a haircut and probably a shave. We have a really nice chicken. It's one of the best chicken statues I've seen in Mexico. All right, let's go get a haircut. So for some reason in this day and age in 2021, a lot of people are losing their minds. A lot of people are going crazy. I think they spend too much time on the internet, and then they spend a lot of time watching the news, or maybe they're just messed up from their parents putting them on prescription drugs when they were children. Who knows? But when you're traveling, especially when you're traveling alone, sometimes you need some company. You want to find some friends to hang out with. So because so many people are crazy, I want to give you guys some tips and pointers on how to detect early warning signs that your travel buddy is insane. Tip number one, they have sudden, incredible, and unexplainable mood swings over trivial matters. So, for example, I was just traveling with somebody just for a few days, and I had made a time to go hiking. I wanted to go on a trek. And they wanted to come. They said, oh, I'd really love to be in your YouTube video, Tony. I'd love to come with you. And so I said, sure, let's leave at noon. And because it was a nice day, I changed my plans. And I said, you know what, it's pretty nice out. Maybe we should leave at 11:30 instead of noon. This person snapped. They lost their mind. They started yelling, saying, leave without me, Tony. I don't want to come anymore. I thought, okay, you know, this person was a little sick. Maybe I was a bit, you know, I could understand that. So, wow, I'm out of breath. The air is really thin up here and I've been sick. I'm out of shape. Look at this view of San Cristobal. Absolutely stunning. It's a beautiful place. So, anyway, this person lost their mind over something so trivial, right? And so I explained to them, no, I just want to leave because the weather's nice and the days are short. Whew. Anyway, that was warning sign number one. So that person, they went, oh, okay, actually, yeah, I still want to come. So the second warning sign was on our trek, this person wanted me to take some selfies for them or some pictures for social media because they were budding social media stars on Instagram. So I started taking the pictures. I took some time to take some beautiful pictures of them. I took about 72 pictures. And when that person was reviewing, they started saying, these are crappy pictures, Tony. These are really bad pictures. And I said, oh, you know, I'm a pretty laid back person. So I thought, oh, okay, I can take some more. But after 1 minute of them complaining about these pictures, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, they started getting more animated, more heated. And I thought, oh no, it's the crazy coming out again. The obsessive compulsive need to, I don't know, rag on somebody, to dominate them, you know, to show that they're right, to have some power. I sensed this and I thought, this is really weird. Like, I just met you. Why would you be harshing on me about your stupid Instagram pictures? We can take plenty of pictures. You have a camera with unlimited memory, pretty much, you know, a smartphone. And so this was the, I almost left at that point because I've been around crazy enough to know that this was a second warning sign. It's that they become obsessive and compulsive over minor details in life, right? So anyway, I took 72 more pictures of that person and then they were happy. Happy enough. The third warning sign, this is the one that you gotta really look out for, but they're afraid. They have a lot of fear of things like animals, bugs, nature, you know, the beasts of the world, snakes, rats, mice, dogs, right? Because this is life. We live in a world full of other creatures, and if someone's really terrified of animals, it's usually a sign that they haven't developed really their core confidence or they have some kind of, you know, disorder, like a mania, a panic disorder. So we were going through the park and some friendly dogs ran up to sniff this person. And I'm not gendering the person either, you know, but they lost their minds. They went, oh my God, oh, the animals, oh. And so when this person had calmed down, you know, because of the dogs, they just wanted to sniff you. I said, you know, that's actually dangerous behavior. It's rather dangerous to freak out around an animal because when you throw that energy around, all the animal feels is crazy energy. Are they dangerous? I better bark at them. Maybe I'll show my teeth because this person might be dangerous. So I said to this person, you know, you need to just calm down a bit around animals and have a bit more of a calm, relaxed energy. Don't be so excitable. And this person lost their freaking mind on me, started screaming at me, saying, oh, you don't know everything. You're not so wise. And that's the ego, right? So when you tell someone the truth quite often, the truth about themselves, the first reaction is often anger, you know, frustration, because you're attacking their identity. That's what it feels like. Like if someone says, oh, Tony, you think you're all this, or you're being such a jerk, or whatever. If they're telling the truth, quite often my first reaction myself is anger, you know, to say, no, you're wrong, you don't know me, freaking out. So this is a sign of a lack of self-awareness, a lack of ego awareness, right? That need to dominate, that need to be right, that need to freak out was also attached to this lack of self-awareness about your own fear, right? And so later on when this person had calmed down, they said to me, Tony, if you have a trauma, you can't change that. You can't change it. And I said, sure you can. You know, it just takes a bit of work and you have to believe in yourself. Use a little bit of psychology. You can use some NLP, some neuro-linguistic programming. You can, you know, use some meditation techniques. You can go and pray to God for help. You can talk to a psychologist. You can get a life coach. You can do all kinds of things to change yourself. You know, I used to be really afraid of people. I had a high social anxiety. I was really scared of being outside and being and talking to people. I'd have panic attacks, but I read lots of books. I took courses. I went to seminars. I took forums. And you know what? I changed myself to become the beacon of confidence and charisma that I am today. I'm flawless. So, you know, anyone, they can really improve themselves. They can do anything they want. You can travel the world. You can start a business. You can go from being afraid of animals to becoming an animal trainer, to becoming the master of animals, right? So the third warning sign that someone is crazy is a high level of fear and anxiety from trivial things like driving in a car, climbing something high, swimming, being around animals, right? It's really hard for me to relate to people who say, I can't, you can't, we can't change. Anyone can change. And so when you know, if you're traveling with somebody and you start to detect all these warning signs, the best thing for you to do is just go your separate way. You know, you can help people. When they say you can't help people, that's bullshit. You can help people, but I'm actually trained in how to help people. And if someone doesn't want it, then you can't help them. They have to say, you know what? I don't like being this way. I want to be better. That's like my life purpose, is to make myself better. I'm not perfect. I've got a big ego sometimes. You know, I've got some depression and anger issues, but I've pretty much overcome them. It took a lot of work. I'm a happy guy. I'm living my dream. I'm self-employed. I'm traveling around. I'm close to my family. I have a small business that brings me money. I feel fulfilled. And I just want other people to feel the same. You know, when people say, I can't, you don't understand, and they have these psychological triggers, it really bothers me and I want to help them, but some people, you just got to let them go their own way. And try to attract the people into your life that are on a similar vibration. Anyway, I'm going to look for this place so I can get my hair cut. I think I found the barbershop. Oh, yes. Hola. Me gustaría un corte de pelo y uno afeitado. Sí? And it's okay, I film. I found the barbershop. Hola. I need to See my haircuts? It's mellow. I'm gonna get a beard shave. Okay. Pequeño. Pequeño. Muy handsome.
Pequeño?
Si. Rico. Rico suave. Si? Yeah. Español.
Ah, sí, ahorita.
¿Ahorita?
Ahorita le corto.
Ahorita le corto.
Ah.
Barba.
Ah.
That's beard.
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 Mustache.
Ah.
Mustache,
beard. We're going to make it pequeño. And I'm going to look like Antonio Banderas. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Antonio Banderas. Not Justin Bieber. No Justin Bieber, Antonio Banderas.
Hey. Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. This guy is Justin Bieber. If she wanted to do me in, now she could.
Yeah.
Can you get one like this? Look at that. I look like I'm 15 years old again. All right. How much is this? Cuánto?
100 pesos.
How much? 10?
100.
Oh, 100. Oh, okay, gracias. 100 pesos, that's 7 Canadian dollars. Pretty good deal for such a wonderful haircut, isn't it? Adios.
Ciao.